Okay, guys.
Okay, Betty, where are you going to sit?
Betty, you want to sit here?
Around, try not to get in the way.
Do you want to sit here?
Well, we're going to have a concert, so I want everyone seated in the
ask me why do I only come with one flute when I used to come with like 10 flutes? And that's because several years ago we had a very good looking young man on a bicycle who insisted as I was putting my stuff away right by the tree, he insisted that the back of his chair was practically against the tree. And since he insisted he put his bicycle in the space between the chair and the tree, which of course is what I had.
Alright.
Hey, don't. He said, well, if I hit the light chair, I will stop. I always want to.
So, we're all here now.
Okay, now, we're all here.
We're all here. So, welcome everybody to the 4th of July.
Yay!
We have our wandering photographer who's recording it for posterity, Susan Young. Thank you, Susan.
Yay!
You know, I do want to say, we don't want any people wandering into this space who are not a part of our group. So if you
can Fort Apache.
Take a little Fort Apache around to be safe. You don't want photographers entering in. And if you don't mind securing the trails to do it, you don't have to just go outside of the animals.
You don't have to mark your area.
You can mark the area. Okay, so before we go to Andrew and Mary,
can you introduce me before I move?
We want to have a minute of silence that's going to be announced by Mark Lamontia. So you want to go ahead?
Okay.
Yeah.
Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Minerva's beautiful thing. Before we do the moment of silence, I want you to look at this. And these are two models that have always been part of this. Gabriella and Christoph. I want to talk about Gabriella. Gabriella was a historical reenactment woman, right? Is that correct? And she would always come dressed like this, and she would explain her costume. Like she had this whole, and you can see in this picture, and it's right here, and she's explaining her
colonial
her costume. In fact, in this, they were said back in the day, they didn't have buttons. They used to sew it in. And not only was, you gotta remember, this is 1600s.
Colonial.
You didn't have Kmart. You couldn't go online to Amazon or go down the street and buy your clothes. You had to make it. So this, what she would explain was, this dress also became your night, your pajamas at night, your night thing. You use this for several different things. And there was padding. She would do this whole explanation, which was really good. I believe she died in a car crash, a head-on collision this past year. So I want you to think of her first. And the funny thing was, you see how she's dressed? When she get into her street clothes, she had beads and dreads. She looked like a Caribbean woman, a white Caribbean woman from the South Bronx. She was a nurse and a midwife. She was really sweet. I didn't know her much, but she was so much a part of this. And I just want you to think about her. Then we go to Christoph. Now, what can I say about Christoph? Christoph, you models are amazing, but Christoph is one of the greats. I've drawn him with clothes on, and I've drawn him without. And he is truly the man of expressions, and I miss him dearly. I knew him better. He passed away from a long bout with cancer. And this is him. I think he was leaning against the chair. And there's two things I remember about Christoph. This is going back to Spring Street. He was posing nude, and he'd be the man of expression. So he wanted to do a hippie high on drugs. He took toilet paper, he made a headband, and then he took his heart medication and dumped it on the stage. And then he took paper, he made a joint, and he went like this. And he held it for 20 minutes. If you knew Christoph, he could hold expressions. He held that. It was hysterical. The second, this is what I remember for him the most. He worked at the Art Students League a lot. He used to post on Facebook. And he always say that, I'm at the office. That's what he would say, I'm at the office. The best thing I remember, he one time did Little Red Riding Hood. He wore the hood and dress, and slacks and shoes. And let me tell you, that man wore dress very well and gave you women a run for his money. I always make him smile. I always think of Christoph. It's him in a dress. He did a lot. He worked that dress and he made me smile. So I want you to remember these two today. We're going to take a moment of silence right now. They were so much a part of this thing. And not only a part, but, you know, she was more a part of this. Christoph was so much a part of Spring, and he was a professional model. He modeled all over. I always want you to remember these two. God rest their souls. Let's take a moment of silence and remember them. One last thing, Andrew and Mary, I've been coming to this for a very long time, and I think it never gets old. I love it, and I appreciate you. Ladies and gentlemen, Andrew.
Thank you. Okay, I'm just going to say something very quickly. All of you are going to be doing some work today, except I don't consider it work, I consider it fun. So be prepared to sing. Don't worry, you have an excellent instructor in terms of Mary Hurlbut. She teaches all over the place. She's queen of the adjuncts, okay? So she's been everywhere and is everywhere, okay? And that's what we're going to do. And then I'm going to introduce a mystery instrument to all of you people, which you will also, I will teach you how to play. It shouldn't take you too long, okay? And I think I have enough of these for everybody. And by the way, they're all packed individually, so in the era of COVID, you're all safe. They've not been played by anybody, and that's what we're going to do. Okay. Mary, would you like to introduce the first piece?
Yeah, this is group participation. And the words are, the earth is our mother, and she will take care of us. And then the next verse is, the earth is our mother, we must take care of her. And then we go back to, Earth is our mother, she will take care of us.
Now, what about the chant, the hey, ya, na?
Yeah, there's a chant in between each verse, which goes, hey, ya, na, ho, ya, na, hey, na, na, hey, ya, na, ho, ya, na, hey, ya, na. That goes at the end of each verse. And Henry is going to be playing the drum. 8 bars, and then we enter. And the tune is, the earth is our mother, she will take care of us. The earth is our mother, she will take care of us. Thanks, Yana.
That this arrangement was done by the late Judith St. Croix, who actually performed for us, I think, in 2017. And she went into the next existence, which everybody's surprised. No one realized she was ill. Okay, so here we go with The Earth is Our Mother. It starts with Henry, and watch Mary for the view.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
nice. Okay, now, this program is going to be a little different. It's sort of very much sectionalized because that's what the past year has been like. That's the best way I can describe it. So we're going to do a brief portion here just to honor Juneteenth. Okay? And I began looking for music for Juneteenth, and it turns out that one of the pieces that we did last year is was on Juneteenth, in any case, but also Amazing Grace. Amazing Grace is considered acceptable. Now, I have a wonderful arrangement of Amazing Grace for flute, written by a friend of mine named Ron Kozak. And I will play that right now. Amazing Grace, arranged for flute by Ron Kozak. Every voice and sing. I had questions when they were discussing the date of Juneteenth, being that it was June 19th, 1865, and the Civil War was ended on, what was it, April 8th? 1865, there was a distance of time, and I thought, boy, those slave owners are trying to squeeze every last bit they could get out.
It wasn't just that the war ended.
Could I finish, please, okay? It turns out that when Lee surrendered, he didn't surrender the whole Confederacy. He surrendered his particular army. And there were a whole bunch of other armies that had to surrender, too, Southern Confederate armies. The last one to surrender was one in the Indian territories of the Native Americans who sided with the Confederacy. And they surrendered in 1866. So, That's why we have it when we have it, okay? And it actually had to do with a proclamation of a general, a Union general who was going to occupy Texas. Okay, yes. Official, that's the Emancipation Proclamation. The actual emancipation was signed in 1863, and they had to wait until the next year, till January 1st, for it to take effect. However, the Emancipation Proclamation only affected those states that were part of the Confederacy. There were four states that still were slave states that were part of the Union. It had no effect on them at all. Okay. Believe me, the more you study this, the worse it gets. That's all I can say. The worse it gets. It's just terrible. Okay, here we go. Lift Every Voice and Sing, which is an absolutely wonderful piece of music. And we're going to do it. Just actually Mary and me, right? Okay.
Lift every voice and sing, till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the heart on knees, on liberty. Let our rejoicing rise, high as the
I took the tenor line.
Books that you see that presented, you just took the tenor line.
I took the tenor line. I did what I do when I play Christmas carols. The same thing. And whatever, it always works out. Okay. Now, that's because the guys who wrote this song obviously clearly did a lot of Christmas carols and harmonized in the same way, so I could do it.
Church singers.
Yes, exactly. Now,
anthem singers.
Right. Now we're going to do some anthems, okay? We're going to have some fun with some anthems, okay? That we all, some of the ones that actually would make very, in my opinion, better contenders in it as a national anthem than the one that we sing, okay? Okay, so the first one we're going to do is God Bless America, okay? And Mary will signal you as to when you will sing, when you'll join in. You watch her. Mary, what is the visual signal you will give to people? Henry's gonna do it. Okay.
I'll be standing up.
Okay, you'll stand up. Okay. That's a very good thing. That's like, years ago I was in an orchestra. We were doing a medley of pieces by Gershwin, and it had a banjo part. Banjo player sits next to me, I'm playing the piccolo with the orchestra. He says, kid, I've never played an orchestra in my life. How do I know when to come in? And as it turns out, the cues for the banjo were in the piccolo part. I said, don't worry, when you're supposed to come in, I'll step on your foot, okay? And it worked fine, okay? That was it. That's something we can all understand. Okay, stepping on your foot. So here we go, we're gonna do God Bless America, and Henry, you gotta follow Uncle Sam, okay?
Behind you.
Okay.
It's drum in hand.
Exactly. Okay, but first you get to hear the lyric through everything else going on. And the arrangement, by the way, of this is Mary's. The part that I play is Mary's arrangement. Okay? I mean, I have to represent the whole orchestra. One little alto flute here. That's it. Okay. Yeah.
When the storm clouds gather across the sea, let the swell be grateful and so fair as we raise our voices in a song of prayer. God bless America.
It's called America, but we know it as My Country Tis of Thee. My Country Tis of Thee. Years ago, I wish I could find this article. Somebody wrote an article, the title of which was What's a Tis of Thee? Okay. Here we go. Now, I'm going to give you an intro, and I guess
everybody join in.
Listen to Mary, I will be giving you the pitches. I'm not going to be doing something fancy. So if you can't hear Mary, maybe you can hear me, and it'll all work out somehow. But first, I've got to give you a lead in so you know where your tonal center is. Okay.
Land where my life
I guess people don't know the third verse.
Okay. Everybody, nobody taught
us. We learned that in school.
Okay.
They don't teach us.
No, that was the third verse. Now, the final one of these candidates, who I think would actually serve much better purposes as a national anthem, is America the Beautiful. Believe me, every one of you attended the third grade, and I'm sure that every one of you had these tunes in the third grade. And they all stood you up there, and your parents came, right? And you looked down, and you saw all the stage lights pop up from the stage, and there was, what was it? There was red, blue, yellow, green. And you looked, wow, so many colors, you see. We all had that. And then we became suckers for showing off to our family. Okay, now, this is America the Beautiful. We're doing verses 1 and 2, okay? If you can't follow it, you can follow what, which president said this? It was actually Bush 1 who said, read my lips, okay? So you look to Mary, or you look, okay, that's what you do. Okay, there's so much you can learn from the Bushes. Okay, here we go. I'm going to give you a lead-in for your tonal center. Here we go. I have to find it myself. Of Allegiance.
Yes.
Okay. A source of much controversy.
Is it under God now or?
Shh. You will learn all, John. Okay? Trust me, you're going to learn all. You're going to even learn that there's a tie-in to contemporary art history in terms of this. Okay? Now, in 1892, it was decided that they had to do something special to commemorate. They certainly did it in the 500th year, the 400th year anniversary of Columbus discovering America. Okay. And so they sent out to different people a contest to write a pledge of allegiance to the flag. There was no pledge for the flag, the United States flag at the time. So a young man named Francis Bellamy, who was, you're going to like this, a Christian socialist, okay? A Christian socialist. They believed that modern day 19th century life was antithetical with the industrial age. It was antithetical to the values of Christ and the Bible. And so the only way you could achieve it was through socialism, okay? So he wrote the first pledge, which goes as follows. I'm going to recite it first, and then we're all going to learn it too, okay? I pledge allegiance to my flag and the republic for which it stands, one nation indivisible with liberty and justice for all. Now we'll do it together, and I'll do it, I'll segment it. We don't have to stand for this. After all, this is entertainment. We don't have a flag here. Notice, there's a reason for that, okay? I pledge allegiance.
I pledge allegiance.
To my flag.
To my flag.
And the republic.
And the republic.
For which it stands.
For which it stands.
One nation indivisible.
One nation indivisible.
With liberty.
With liberty.
And justice for all.
And justice for all.
Okay, now, that was good enough for the country from 1892 to 1923, at which point it was decided that because of the large influx of immigrants coming in 1923, including my father, by the way, in 1923, that if they pledged to my flag, they'd be pledging to the flag of the country they just left. You see, their native flag, not the United States. So it was changed, and it became, I pledge allegiance to the flag and republic for which it stands, one nation indivisible with liberty and justice for all. Let us recite that together so we all know this. I pledge allegiance to the flag
and republic
for which it stands.
One nation indivisible.
With liberty and justice for all. Well, okay, what happened then, during the year that followed, was the DAR got involved, the Daughters of the American Revolution, and said, no. We still don't know what country this is, okay? So, then it became, I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Let us all do that together. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And that was good enough from 1924 until 1954. And then you had the specter of communism, okay? And with the encouragement of Dwight David Eisenhower, one more element was added to the consternation of true believers in democracy and what a government is supposed to be about. And that was the addition of under God. I actually, and I'm sure you remember, John, when you stood and did the pledge, there was no under God. I actually kind of remember that.
Don't remember.
I mean, aside from throwing spitballs at kids, that's what we did. Okay, so we're going to do the pledge as it stands now, just to show that we're loyal Americans, okay? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Now, one more thing. This is for your education. It's very important. They didn't have this pledge when you stood up there with your hand on your heart, you know, like this. That didn't exist. That came in 1942. Instead, what they had was the following, something called the Bellamy Pledge, in honor of the man who wrote the first pledge. And what you did there was, you did a salute like this, okay? And then you extended your arm out, your right arm out, palms up, and you did this. Ah, now you see, there's a difference between this and this, you see, okay? Nazis and fascists did this, okay? Americans did this, which is, behold, the flag. That was the idea. But they had to change it to this, and they did that because there's no confusion, okay? I will give you, if I can find directions on, as to how to pledge. We were not going to do it now. I'll tell you why. Because if the parks people see a whole bunch of people doing this, okay, they'll probably, the cops will be down here in a flash, and we'll all be arrested. And you'll say, well, I was just doing the Bellamy salute. And they'll say, what the hell is that? Okay, so I'm going to read you the directions, which sound like they're for Boy Scouts in schools. Okay. At a signal from the principal, the pupils in ordered ranks, hands to the side, face the flag. Another signal is given. Every pupil gives the flag the military salute. Right hand lifted, palm downward to align with the forehead and close to it. All repeat slowly together, I pledge allegiance to my flag. At the words to my flag, the right hand is extended gracefully, palm upward towards the flag and remains in this gesture until the end of the affirmation. Okay, whereupon, all hands drop to the side, whoop, like that. Okay, now you know how to be good citizens in the year, 1892. Okay, we're in good shape. And that went all the way up to 1942. Okay, now, we're going to do the Star Spangled Banner. And I'm not going to say any more about the Star Spangled Banner, except that the guy who wrote it, he didn't write the original tune, and he was a slave owner, and the third verse of this, they only play the first verse now because the rest of it is so reprehensible, they're not going to use it. But no one's going to backtrack and say, maybe we should do another anthem instead. So they just say, well, we'll only do the first verse. So that's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to do the first verse.
Can we stand up?
Yes, everybody needs to stand up. But we have no flag, so it doesn't really
count. I have a flag here.
I'm wearing a flag.
I have flags here.
You have flags here?
Yeah.
Oh, dear God.
Oh, there's Henry.
Henry has flags. My God.
Henry is a flag.
Okay.
Do you need a flag?
That's commerce and capitalism.
Okay.
Georgette and
I like the shirt. I'm wearing it.
Okay, well, guess what? We've got a flag.
You're not taking it off, of course.
No.
There you go.
I can wear whatever I want. I'm a great person.
Well, actually.
And it costs $8 in
college. A flag has to be a real flag today. Okay. As a card carrying Cub Scout and Boy Scout. It's okay, but whatever you do, don't drop it. Okay? I mean, if you've ever been a Boy Scout, this is serious stuff. You don't drop the flag. That's it. Okay? Otherwise, you know what we have to do? There are two things you have to do. Either you bury it or you burn it. What?
A rabbi can
get it. That's great. That's a new one for me. You can coacherize your flag.
Muscle top.
Okay,
ready? You
want to stand
next
to me? I know, John. Okay. Okay, let me give you the intro so you all know your total centers, okay? You have to have your total centers. Okay, That's exactly. Okay, let me do the intro.
Stripes and bright stars through the perilous.
this is not the end of the program. Okay? No worries.
How long is it?
This song actually stands for the War of 1812. The War of 1812 was the siege of Fort whatever, and Francis Scott Key was on the British side because he was there to arrange, he was under truce, to arrange the release of a friend of his. That's what he was able to do. Okay, so he wrote the lyrics. Francis Scott Key wrote that lyric, but he did not write the tune, although he's credited with that. The tune was from an English drinking society, a gentleman's club called the Anacreontic Club. And it's called the Anacreontic Song. And it's all about drinking and merriment and stuff like that. Now the group was very cultivated. Later on, when Franz Joseph Haydn left Hungary and he went on a tour of England, he was a guest of the Anacreontic Club and they funded performances of his music in London. So it's a little more than whatever it is. Okay, now let me make sure my music is fashioned tightly. Okay, so this is going to be Mary singing the original song, the Anacreontic song. And put two verses?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, since I'm playing a C, it'll be a G.
To Anacreon in heaven, where he sat in glory, a few songs of harmony sang.
Playing kazoos. Okay? This was a wonderful idea on the part of my daughter. Okay? She thought this would be a wonderful thing for everybody to do. And she actually went and got me the kazoos. Okay? That's something. Okay?
No.
Anyhow, so let me get the kazoos ready. I've got to find them.
All right. Fade out, fade in.
Under, and we have the Marines hymn, okay? All which will be done, rendered on kazoos. Now, people have to come forward so I can give them kazoos, okay? Here's a kazoo. Okay, and I'll give you instructions, okay? Yes, not anything out. Here.
So any model who's working inside can go inside now. But if you're working outside, you're
I'll tell you what, the fact is, right now I don't, but the thing is that what I've got to do is I've got to head out to shoes. So I'm sorry, I'd love to talk to you about it. No, just a little bit later today. Okay.
Kazoo.
Okay. What's it?
You want to bring a kazoo?
Yes, here's one for your mom, okay? Mom. We'll have enough. Don't worry. Any more kazoos?
Another model.
More kazoos. Everyone get a kazoo.
Hum. Hum at the end. The short end.
Freddie, you can stay or you can go over there, whichever you want. And Mohawk.
Short end, and you hum into it. Hum into it. You have one? Hum into it.
I got to get another bag.
We still have plenty of kazoos.
I only have three mouths.
No, she doesn't want a kazoo. Okay. I'm not interested in water right now. I'm interested in getting kazoos to people. Now, Betty, would you like a kazoo?
No, I'm sorry.
You're sorry you don't want a kazoo. Okay, now. As everybody who wants a kazoo has a kazoo. Now, there's a man who wants a kazoo. He has a change of heart. Here you go. Kazoo time. Now, any more kazoos? Because this is final call on kazoos. Okay. Now, this is what you do with a kazoo if you haven't been kazooed. You put the short end in your mouth. The short end, not the long end, the short end. The short end, Minerva, that's the long end.
Oh, you mean the full end.
The short end.
The short end. Jesus
Christ. You teach anatomy.
No, but short is the, I didn't see.
Long end.
Short and height.
Short end.
And
mouth.
I thought it's short and height.
Mouth. Short end.
But I saw the height of it. Short.
Okay. Hum in a lusty fashion. Hum. For God's sake, don't be shy. My daughter, bless her soul, she's the one who came up with this idea. Then we practiced it, and I had her play the kazoo. And my daughter, she's so refined. She goes, and I say, no, dear. You know, you're a performer. You have to put it out, you know.
The cobbler's children will go barefoot. The musician's children will go off silent.
That's right, exactly.
Not a note out of their vocal cord.
Not a note.
You guys have been loud enough. Let her be quiet.
Okay, now.
I got it.
Now, this is what we're going to do. I'm going to change my name to his name. You know, there was a judge in New York named Bruce. Oh, God, I can't remember his last name now. But anyhow, he was referred to as Turn Him Loose Bruce. And so my name will now be Turn Him Loose Bruce, because you see, I introduced kazoos to Minerva's Art School, and the world changed forever. Changed absolutely forever. Okay, now, the first song we're going to do is the Army song, the caisson song. I will accompany you on the flute so you get a side idea of the tonal pitches that we're trying for. And Mary will sing the lyrics. And you shall hear from the two of us basically what you should be trying to emulate pitch-wise. But for God's sakes, you're kazoos. So keep the character of kazoos going, okay? You're not a soprano. You're not an alto flute. You're a kazoo, a proud kazoo.
G-flat.
That's what you are, okay? Okay. By the way, you get to keep your kazoo. You can take your kazoo home with you, no problem. Okay, and you can
annoy your children.
You know, charm your husband, charm your wife, charm your significant other. Believe me, the partnership won't last. But you'll be free. Okay, anyhow, here we go. I'm going to do the intro. Once I can see, my God, the light's so much better and I can't see. Here we go. This is I'm in the Key of for you, F.
Okay.
One is good enough on that one. Okay, now anchors away, because of its brevity, we'll do it twice, okay? Twice, because there's nothing like anchors away, I'll tell you. It just moves me, you know, like nothing else. Okay, I'm gonna give you... I'm going to give you a lead in, and then you can listen to me or you can listen to Mary. Okay? It's anchors away. Twice. And again, you don't need to know the lyrics. You're kazooists. What is it, Minerva?
No, I'm just thinking it. I have models up to be at the other studio unless they're participating.
I understand, Minerva.
I just wanted to make sure Jan and the four models go on there unless they want to participate. Okay. Because they're here participating or they're.
I got it. Okay. Okay. I got it. Someday. Okay. Let me give you the lead into anchors away.
Order, classicism.
Okay. Order and classicism. Now that you've solved the problem of the models, now we're going to be in the Navy. Okay? Anchors away. I give you a lead in. Watch Mary. Listen to me. Watch and listen to Mary. Like the sound of 20 mighty kazoos playing in concert.
Okay? We can hear it, but we're just playing our own. We can't hear it because all we hear is our own.
Oh, well, it's wonderful.
So we'll see it on the video. We'll hear it.
That's what performing is about, Minerva. You have to hear yourself, you have to hear what everybody else is doing, and you have to hear what your placement is like with your melody. And then, of course, then you
get... Thank God I'm an artist.
Oh, it gets worse, because then you get into orchestral politics. Okay, now, here we go. This is off we go into the wild blue yonder. Okay, now I'll give you a lead in, and again, the key for you will be G.
Please clap.
Oh,
is the Marine Corps hymn. And much to my surprise, as I was copying out a part for myself, I discovered that the Marine Corps hymn, the music, was written by the French opera composer Jacques Offenbach. Of all people, Jacques Offenbach wrote the Marine Corps. If the Marines could see a picture of what Jacques Offenbach would look like.
What about supposed to print the melody for an opera?
Yeah,
for an opera. He didn't write
an opera.
That's correct.
He wasn't commissioned. He wasn't commissioned. Oh God, he wrote hundreds. Yeah. I mean, that's it.
Dad, you're doing at the other place. You were here at 1:30. Yeah.
Let the Marines take Tarawa,
Iwo Jima, I'm sorry, but I
Corregidor. Okay, let them do
it. I
know. Okay. Okay. Now you just dropped your kazoo here. Okay. No, you didn't. But, no, don't put it in your mouth. I'll give you another one. Okay. This is the Marine for him, written by Jacques Offenbach, and I've got to give you your lead in. Here we go.
I want you to move on that stool. I don't know what to say. She's creating a thing from this model. Can you move over here?
It's very hard on my back.
Oh. It's okay. She can move. Where do I go?
I thought it was 2 minutes. The pose is 2 minutes. Is that a photo or a video?
Okay.
Yeah. 2 minutes.
Yeah.